looking for the King of Podcasts? You're at the wrong channel. Looking for good ideas for life? You are far from good hands. If you think the listener is always right, you are far from the right place. Hosted by a Northeasterner by birth, a rebel by choice. If you want a host that floats between love and madness, then play on and listen to Crazy Train Radio.
What up, Crazy Train Radio?
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
I love scotch. I love scotch. Scotchy, scotch, scotch. Here it goes down, down into my belly.
Don't mess with me, I'm one crazy mofo.
With over 30 years of experience and a superb reputation for being a detail-oriented company, Lacey Cleaning has some of the highest work standards in the cleaning business.
That's the fact, Jeff!
Whether it's carpet cleaning, tile, grout cleaning, new construction cleanup, rental turnovers, vent and duct cleaning, odor elimination, office and or business cleaning, power washing, residential cleaning, you name it, they do it. Check them out. To contact them today, LaceyCleaning@gmail.com or call them at 609-709-8536.
That's what I'm talking about.
Are you annoyingly even keel? Emethamine could be right for you.
I have a disease, all right? I need help!
Emethamine lets you get gagged up on whoop chicken parts without yellowing one's teeth. Contact your doctor today if you experience the following.
Oh my god!
Increases in blood flow, boost in testosterone, ending of erectile dysfunction. This medicine is made for extreme cases of being even keel or having extreme depression.
Oh, come on!
Side effects include fits of rage, acne, bleeding in folks around you, whooping cough, hallucinations, comas, trouble swallowing, decrease in semen, increase in amounts of selling yourself, amnesia, night terrors, higher mortgage rates, and increased sensations in not having suicidal urges.
Oh my.
Hi, this is Amanda Wist, and you're listening to Crazy Train Radio.
Hey folks, it's your least favorite host in a podcast world, a croc, Jonathan Steele. And boy, do we have a good one for you today.
She has a new horror anthology coming out on September 5th for its official release. You want to get more details, not only on this project, not in a Blessed Thought and Skunk Home, but she is also the owner of Editing Me, that's with two E's on the end, you'll have links below. Elizabeth Suggs, how you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Oh, no complaints on my end. First and foremost, the new horror anthology. What can you tell us about it?
So for Collective Darkness, it's really exciting because it's my very first horror anthology. And that's just, the collective stories. So, and one really cool thing about it is that it's 12 local authors from where I am. It's in Utah. And we also have 4 narrators because we're going to have it also on Audible and different audiobook sites. So it's pretty exciting. And then the theme is darkness. So everyone, all authors wrote about how darkness is in their story, you know, so for me, it was like the monster within the corner, but then, you know, someone else had the darkness within the fog of their story. So it was really interesting to see how everyone took that theme. I'm really excited to, read it all together. So.
Now, would you say that these stories are more like, I always have a problem with this word, novels, almost like what a Clive Barker would do, or are they each like full-blown stories?
So they're pretty short. Longest story is about, and it is our longest story, so it's like, I believe 10,000 words. And so that's maybe like 15 pages, 15, 20 pages, give or take on like font and size. But most of the stories are about 5,000 words. And so that's about, 3 to 5 pages. So it just kind of depends on if you're, how big your font is on like the ebook or if it's on the printed copy. But we've tried to keep them pretty short just so you can have like really digestible stories compared to large novellas, at the 20,000 words, or novels at like 60 or 80. But our stories, so there are 12 different ones, right? And so all of our stories together is a little less than 60,000 words. So what that means is it's about 150 pages total of the entire book. So you could honestly read it within like a night and, or listen to it within it. We just wanted it pretty short so you could kind of just get a taste of everything.
Now, as you mentioned, it's 12 different stories by 12 different authors. Hold on one second.
Oh, what else can I tell you?
I had to excuse myself there. Didn't hear me.
No, I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
Okay. So anyway, as you mentioned, this is 12 different authors and 4 different stories here. Now, are all the stories intertwined or are they all different stories, would you say?
Oh, they're all different stories. So some have more of a fantasy horror, and then some are just strictly horror. So yeah, they're all just different.
Right on. So obviously you can go to the site to get the book or get the audio versions. It'll give you links to the Amazon and all like this. But what I want to touch on as well is the other website that you have in editing me, E's on the end there, .com. What can you tell us about that website and what actually got you into doing not only the anthology, but this main website as well?
Right. So all of it together, I really want to help people and authors especially. A lot of writing it seems like it can be easy, but that's the, it's a whole mess of stuff when you want to get things published. And so I want to help writers, you know, kind of go through that in, like, if you need to format your story, because sometimes formatting is really hard. And I, you know, I teach classes on that, or I just will help them with, you know, or with editing. And, you know, there's different tiers of editing. So, like, if you need just light editing compared to some really heavy editing. And then also, you know, marketing, you know, either strategies or just, you know, helping out the writer. So, and then publishing as well. And the publishing is with these different anthologies. So this year we're doing Collective Darkness. But next year, it's going to be a collective fantasy, and I will occasionally help others publish their books as well. So one person just helped them with their children's book, Quincy's Questions, and then another one, I'm helping someone create a cookbook. So, yeah, I just my whole goal and is just, you know, getting authors out there. The anthologies are some of the easiest ways because you can get a whole bunch of new and emerging authors all in one. So then they can, by telling all their friends on social media, they're also helping the other authors. So it's just a pretty easy way to get everyone's voice out there and help each other.
Well, you mentioned a good point there about, yeah, as far as people might think of editing being easy, or not editing, writing in the process itself.
Yeah.
What is, would you say, the biggest challenge that you've seen as far as putting anthologies or books or any type of writing together and out there published that most people who want to be authors may not realize?
Well, so one of the biggest things that I've found is most authors and, you know, just new and emerging, so, you know, both have gotten published and not published, and also unpublished, is that sometimes they don't start the story where it actually is supposed to start, especially in anthologies. So in like collected works, like, you know, short story collections, you want to start almost immediately in the action, or, you know, you'll lose the reader and you don't have a lot of time compared to a novel. But honestly, even in a novel, sometimes you won't. There's a thing in stories, no matter what story, you know, short story or in a big book, there's the inciting action. And if you don't have that inciting action established really early on in your story, you could lose readers. And so a lot of authors may not realize that. So sometimes we have to cut, you know, five pages, like the first five pages, because it's just not really going anywhere. So that's one thing I will tell authors to watch out for, that if they get rejected often and they're not really sure why, because they have good grammar and they have a good story, it might be because they're not starting the story in the most eye-catching spot. Because you have to have, your first paragraph has to be very eye-catching. You know, an editor or a publisher, they might lose interest, you know, if you don't have it exciting. And so that would be the thing that I find most authors do.
Well, folks, if you want to check out this new project or get in touch with Elizabeth about possibly help, we mentioned we'll have the links below on all formats of this episode. But I want to ask before I let you go, social media, because obviously that's a big deal and people think they can write, and I'm not saying this in a bad way, via social media, but it's a whole different ball game compared to writing a post or a tweet or anything than a book. Mm-hmm. But social media-wise, how can they find you guys as well?
So on social media, if you want to get in contact with me, is that you would just go on to, if you go on to either the Editing Me website or Collective Darkness, you will see the icons, but you can find us if you just search Collective Darkness or Editing Me either on Twitter, on Instagram, and on Facebook. And we're starting up YouTube. YouTube's kind of slow because we're just barely getting it up and running. But Facebook and Instagram are our two biggest ones. If you search on any of those four, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook, you'll find us, either Collective Darkness or Editing Me, or even my name if you want to look me up. My name, on all of those, if you just honestly, if you just Google me, Elizabeth Suggs, you'll find me. I believe I'm one of the first on there. So, and you can just get me or just search me on the social media as well.
And just let me do search, folks. Please like, share, and subscribe because these projects are pretty cool. And like we said, Breath of Darkness comes out on the 5th, so what a way to start out your Labor Day weekend there, but to get a little spooky. Elizabeth, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate coming on your show.
Not all football helmets are created equal. Zenith, the industry leader in protective technology, is the only helmet in the game with adaptive head protection featuring a shock suspension system that can move independently from the helmet shell. Headquartered and developed in Detroit, Zenith is committed to player safety and revolutionary innovation. Zenith is proud to protect athletes at every level from peewee to the pros. Learn more about the Zenith difference at zenith.com. That's XENITH.com.
Wow!
Thinking your day is bad and really looking to make it worse? Why not try downloading this new classic set of music that will be dropping so far off the charts, there's bound to be injuries. Now that's what I call depressing. It's gonna make those who are even close to having the slightest glimmer of hope wanna jump off the highest of planks. For those that are getting Now That's What I Call Depressing, you'll be getting that song that reminds you of that relationship with those cougars, Wrinkled Ladies. For those who weren't really into cougars, but those who had that special friend whilst in Cell Block 2B, we got for you this clusterfuck that will put you in therapy for years to come. With cheeks wide open. Who the fuck writes this shit? Oh hell, we're still recording this commercial.
Always with you, it cannot be done.
Those that rather have it out than in. This loaded hit will be dropping soon, farthing in the USA. For those who place their order by calling or ordering online, the next 100 folks will receive their choice of either a noose of good quality that won't snap, an installation of a new outlet next to your bathtub so you can now blow dry your hair in a full tub, or the choice of the right gang to just beat the fuck out of you. Call us today at 1-800-FUCK-THIS.
Hey campers, this is Artie Lee, the first Jason Voorhees from Friday the 13th, and you're listening to Crazy Train Radio. Jason never dies.